Hi viewers, welcome to my channel. So this is Srinivas Reddy, presently working as academic dean and senior faculty in India's topmost institution, Sri Chaitanya Education Institutions. Today my lecture is about the series Getting an Extra Edge. You will be preparing for the entrance examinations, especially for IIT JEE Advanced. After the preparation of your chapter for the first time, definitely you must go through previous examination questions. What are the previous questions asked in JEE Advanced? So you can check where you are by solving those questions. So these videos of Getting an Extra Edge is regarding that. So an analysis of JEE Advanced questions on what concepts regularly in the chapter the examiner is asking, what is the examiner mind, on which aspects he wants to check your knowledge in the exam, on what accuracy you must have to get the correct answer or answers, because there will be different pattern of questions in the examination, especially how to deal with the different pattern of questions. My sincere attempt to analyze the examination questions. So in the first video I am going to discuss the latest paper, Advanced Question Paper 2020. Chapter wise I will be discussing paper 1 and paper 2. So in this first video I am going to discuss the questions asked in Advanced 2020, both paper 1 and paper 2, in vector algebra. So vector algebra is very important chapter in terms of JEE Advanced. In Advanced 2020 you got two questions in vector algebra. Let us analyze the questions given in JEE Advanced 2020. So first question, what I have wrote here, is in vectors. This is more than one correct answer type. So this is for given for plus 4. Part marks will be there. So in multiple correct, in Advanced 2020, part marks are also given. So that means if all the options are correct for you, you will be given plus 4 marks. If some options are correct for you, you will be given part marks also. Look at this question. Look at this question given in JEE Advanced 2020. So first step to get success is studying properly the question. So what the question he has given, and that first analysis must be regarding the question. On the given information, you must concentrate, because it is more than one correct answer. Question and its geometrical interpretation or diagram, whatever the given information is, you have to observe. Look at the question here. So A comma B are positive real numbers given. So P Q bar is AI plus BJ, P S bar is AI minus BJ, are adjacent sides of a parallelogram PQRS. So there is a parallelogram PQRS. So adjacent sides are given. So let U bar and V bar be the projection vectors of another vector given, W bar equal to I cap plus J cap.
along PQ bar and PS bar of the parallelogram respectively, and one condition is given: if modulus U bar plus modulus V bar equal to modulus W bar, and if the area of parallelogram PQRS is 8 given, this is the information given. Then he is asking which of the following statements is slash R true, that means one or more than one correct. So look at what he has given is a parallelogram. So for the time being, draw parallelogram to get the information what he has given and what he is asking. Let us draw a parallelogram. Let us analyze in detail about what he has given and what he is asking, and then we will go further. Right? This is PQRS given parallelogram. Let us say this is given. So then adjacent sides are given PQ bar. So this vector is given clearly, AI plus BJ, this is vector given, and then this vector is given. AI minus BJ, we will see different approaches of this problem. So this is given, and he has given another vector W bar, we will come to that. Now this is the parallelogram adjacent sides given, right? So clearly magnitude PQ length is nothing but, PQ length is nothing but magnitude of PQ bar. This is root of A square plus B square. This length is what? Root of A square plus B square, this length. Similarly, PS is nothing but modulus PS bar, magnitude of the vector. So this is also root of A square plus B square, right? So therefore, this side length and this side length are equal. That means adjacent sides are equal means this side and opposite side will be equal, this side and opposite side will be equal. That means all sides will be equal. First, whenever a parallelogram is given, you analyze what is that, whether it is square or rhombus or rectangle or parallelogram like that. So therefore, it is clear that adjacent sides are equal means all the sides will be equal. All sides equal. So all sides equal means we will get an idea. So that means it is square or rhombus. All sides equal means what happens? It can be square or rhombus. It can be square or rhombus. Square or rhombus, we cannot say. So look at here. So let us analyze whether it is square or rhombus if any information is given. So another information is also given: modulus of U bar plus modulus V bar equal to modulus W bar. Another information is given. He is telling that U bar and V bar be the projection vectors of W bar equals to I plus J. So look at, there is a vector I plus J. Let us say I am plotting a vector I plus J. So let us say this is I plus J, let us say Lm. There is a vector this is W bar given, right? So he is telling that let u bar and v bar be the projection vectors of this along pq bar and ps bar. Projection vectors means what? Projection vectors means, we will discuss about this concept. Look at it. I will explain the concept here, what is behind that. So main projection means, projection of a vector A bar along or on B bar. B bar means, look at here, what is the concept involved here is, there is a vector. There is a vector, let us say B bar is like this, B bar is like this, B bar, let us say it is like this, and there is another vector, let us say CD. So let us say this is A bar. There is another vector. There is another vector. Projection of A bar on B bar means nothing is there. From the initial point of A bar, drop a perpendicular on vector B bar. This is the vector. From the initial point, drop a perpendicular on B bar. Let us say this is E. So from the terminal point, you drop a perpendicular, let us say this is EF. This is nothing but EF. This EF is called projection of a vector A bar along B bar. This A bar along B bar means this EF length. This is nothing but, look at here, what is the formula? A bar dot. Projection of A bar on B bar means A bar dot unit vector along this direction AB bar. What is the unit vector? Vector is B bar. Unit vector is what? B cap. Projection of a vector A bar in the direction of B bar is nothing but this magnitude. EF bar means inside vector. A bar dot B cap. EF bar means vector. EF bar you have to write means, EF bar means vector. EF bar means vector. EF bar means this length into unit vector. EF length means magnitude. Projection of vector or length of projection of vector A bar along B bar, that means along B bar means on B bar, is nothing but this length. If you want to calculate A bar dot unit vector in the direction of B bar, this EF is called this length. Modulus I have written because it must always be positive. EF bar is nothing but length of that vector EF. This is the length of that vector into along EF bar. What is the vector? B cap. So projection of a vector on A bar along B bar on B bar is nothing but modulus of A bar dot on which you are taking projection, A bar dot B cap. Here look at it. There is a vector W bar given. Projection of this W bar on PQ, look at, I am dropping perpendiculars from this. So let us say this is A. I am dropping perpendicular on this. So let us say this is B. This is B. This is B. So projection of W bar on PQ is nothing but AB. This vector is given, this vector is given U bar. This vector is given U bar. Now projection of LM, LM bar on PS bar. Now look at, I am drawing perpendicular from L upon PS. I have dropped a perpendicular. I have dropped a perpendicular, and from here I am dropping a perpendicular. This is W bar. This is W bar. So AB. So this is U bar. Let us say this is CD. So this is V bar given. This is V bar given. So therefore, projection of W bar on PQ is nothing but AB bar, that is given U bar, right? Projection of W bar on PS bar, that means CD bar, that is given as V bar. Now look at what is the information given. Modulus U bar plus modulus V bar equal to modulus W bar. This, so now modulus U bar is nothing but this length he is asking, this length AB plus modulus V bar means this length CD is their projection. So this CD, that means length of the projection. This is nothing but modulus W bar means this is given I plus J. That means magnitude of that is what? Root 2. Root 2. Now AB, look at. AB is nothing but length of projection of W bar on PQ bar. PQ bar is nothing but AI plus BJ. Now look at here. Length of projection of A bar on B bar. Here A bar is what? W bar. B bar is what? PQ bar. Length of projection of W bar on PQ bar. AB is nothing but modulus W bar dot unit vector in the direction of PQ bar. B cap, that means PQ cap plus CD, look at CD. CD is nothing but CD bar. CD is nothing but length of projection of W bar on PS bar. That means here A bar is W bar, B bar is nothing but PS bar. Therefore, what is that? W bar dot PS cap. So this is given as root 2. I am explaining the concepts with the problem. This, so therefore, you can write what is this? W bar means given I plus J dot unit vector in the direction of PQ bar. PQ bar you know. So this is PQ bar. Unit vector means what? Vector divided by its magnitude. Divided by root of A square plus B square. So this is the one plus modulus W bar dot, that means I plus J dot PS cap. PS cap is nothing but PS is nothing but AI minus BJ, that vector divided by its magnitude. Root of A square plus B square. So this is given root 2. This is given root 2. From this you can find a relation AB. Look at here. Write the dot product. This dot, this means what? Modulus A plus B divided by root of A square plus B square plus modulus A minus B divided by root of A square plus B square is nothing but root 2. I want to find a relation in AB because he is asking, first two options are AB, A minus B values. Because if you find AB values, then parallelogram everything you will know. Then you can calculate what is diagonal and about what is A plus B, what is A minus B. Now look, here what you are getting is, root 2 into root of A square plus B square. So both sides positive quantities are there. Now squaring on both sides, obviously we will do squaring on both sides, squaring on both sides, right? So this is A plus B whole square plus A minus B whole square plus two AB. These are real numbers only. So equals to 2 into A square plus B square. A square plus B square. Now A plus B whole square plus A minus B whole square is nothing but 2 into A square plus B square. So therefore you got, so this 2 into modulus of A square minus B square equal to 0. Right? So this concludes that as A, B are real numbers, A square minus B square equal to 0. A square minus B square equal to 0. So therefore, A is nothing but less or minus P. But given that AB are positive, so since A greater than 0, B greater than 0, as both are positive, A cannot be minus B. Because if A equal to minus B, this side positive, that side negative quantity will be there. Therefore, we can make sure that A equal to B, because given that AB are positive quantities. Now concluded, A equal to B. This is what we want, a relation in AB. Because here, coming back to the problem, we have decided that these two adjacent sides are equal. Now all sides are equal. Then it can be square or rhombus. It can be square or rhombus. When it will be square? If this angle is there, this angle, if it is 90, it will become square. Then all angles will be what? 90 degrees. If angle between adjacent sides is 90 degree, it will become square. If it is not 90 degree, it will become a rhombus. Now, A equal to B concludes here. It is a square because PQ bar dot PS bar, look at. PQ bar dot PS bar. We will calculate the dot product of those two. Look at. We concluded A equal to B. So we concluded the problem A equal to B. So I am calculating angle between adjacent sides. PQ bar dot PS bar is nothing but this dot this. That means we are getting A square minus B square. As A equal to B, this will become 0. This will become 0, therefore square. Therefore it is what? Square. So now the problem is over. Once you come into the conclusion that it is a square, your problem is completely over. Your problem is completely over. Now area given. Area of square equal to area of square is given 8. Area of given 8. That means area is what? Length of the side square. Each side square equal to 8. Equal to 8. What is PQ? What is PQ? A square plus B square. A square plus B square equal to 8. So now you can find, or otherwise PQ you can find out. PQ is nothing but 2 root 2. PQ is nothing but 2 root 2. PQ is nothing but 2 root 2. So therefore PQ you got, that means PQ square is nothing but A square plus B square equal to 8. Now you can calculate what is A and B. So this gives 2A square equal to 8. So as A is positive, A equal to 2, that means that is also equal to what? That is also equal to B. So don't take plus or minus 2 because it is given positive. That means we can conclude that A plus B equal to 4. So first option is correct. First option is correct. Now if you look at the second option, A minus B is 2 given, that is wrong. A minus B is what? 2 minus 2, that is 0. So this is wrong. Like that, after coming to a conclusion that it is square, analyze the answers. Now look at, easily you will get length of diagonal PR. Now look at PR, this is root 8, this is root 8. This is root 8. So therefore, PR is nothing but root of PQ square plus QR square. This is the diagonal. This is the diagonal. So this length is root 8. This length is root 8. So root of 8 plus 8. That means 4. So that you got easily, because length of the side, you know. Length of the side, you know. Now he is telling W bar is angular bisector of PQ bar and PS bar. Now look at, so this is a square. This is a square, right? This is a square. So for PQ bar and PS bar, as it is a square, PR is angular bisector. Of PQ and PS. Because it is a square, not in all parallelograms. In square or rhombus, diagonal is the angular bisector of adjacent sides. Any diagonal will be angular bisector of adjacent sides. Now look at, PR is the angular bisector of PQ and PS. Now PR bar you can calculate. Look at, PR bar I am calculating by parallelogram law, PQ bar plus PS bar. PQ bar plus PS bar, that means this plus this, that gives 2AI. 2AI, that means A is what? 2, 4I. Now he is asking W bar is an angular bisector. When W bar will be angular bisector, the W bar line of action, that W bar if it is like this, that vector if it is like this, that the W bar is there, if it is like this, that vector is there, if it is like this, it is an angular bisector. Or the W bar, if it is like this, it can be in this direction also. That means that W bar vector, if it is like this, it is called an angular bisector, or if it is like this, it is said to be an angular bisector of those. Now, that means we can say, if W bar is collinear with PR bar, if W bar and PR bar are collinear, then we can say that W bar is an angular bisector of PQ and PS. Now, PR bar we have calculated. So, W bar is what? I plus J. Look at here, PR bar is 4i vector, this is 4i vector, right? W bar is I plus J vector. These two are collinear. Look at, these two are not collinear because W bar cannot be written as some constant into, when they are collinear vectors, how they can be written? One vector equals some scalar into other vector, therefore they are not collinear. Is not collinear with the diagonal vector. So therefore, this is wrong. Option D is what? It cannot be angular bisector. It is an angular bisector means its line of action will be along the line PR. That means what? W bar must be collinear with PR bar. That is not possible. Therefore, this option is wrong. This option is wrong. Therefore, ACR correct. ACR correct. Right? This is one approach. The main thing is here he wants to apply this formula. Projection of a vector A bar. If you know this, you can do the problem. Vector A bar on B bar. A B bar. This is nothing but A bar dot. Whenever you are finding projection of A bar along a vector B bar or on vector B bar, length of projection, that length if you want, EF, you write modulus of A bar dot B cap. This vector EF bar if you want, you write that length EF into unit vector in the direction of EF bar. This is the main formula. This is one approach. Right? So, we have concluded that it is a square. After concluding it is a square, you got the sides. Every side is 2 root 2. Right? Every side is 2 root 2 means PQ already you know. We have calculated AB that you got. And if each side of the square is known, you can calculate what is the diagonal. This is one approach. Suppose while solving the problem, while you have started the problem, somebody will get some clever ideas. Look at another approach to solve the problem. Indirect approach. To solve the problem is, suppose you got the idea like this, okay. The same problem, suppose you got the idea like this. We will proceed according to another idea. Look at how you can solve in another method, let us see. Right. Some clever method we will take. So first we have concluded all sides equal, that is over. By looking at this you can say that all sides equal we have concluded. Right? First, let us take it is a square. First, we will solve the problem trickily. Let PQRS be a square. Let us check. That may not be a square, but let us take. Some clever idea you must give in the exam. Let PQRS be a square. Square means what happens? If you have taken like this, on solving the problem, then you will get different ideas. If it is a square, what happens? Let us take. After that, we will check. whether it is y, whether we have taken is correct or not, we will come to a conclusion. Dot this is equal to 0, that implies a square minus b square equal to 0. That implies as a, b are positive, we will get a equal to b over. If you have taken it is a square, then obviously you got a equal to b. A equal to b. Now area is given. Let us solve the problem now for your square case. So that means side square equal to 8. So what is each of length, each side length? This is 2 root 2 over, in single step it will be over. Each side length is what, 2 root 2. Therefore, he is asking the diagonal. He is asking the diagonal. PR is nothing but root of PQ square plus QR square. It is a square. So, root of 8 plus 8 over. So, directly you got, what is that? Length of diagonal, PR equal to 4. PR equal to 4. Now, about AB, another problem. So AB means PQ is nothing but, PQ is nothing but 2 root 2. This implies we will get A square plus B square equal to 8, squaring on both sides. As A equal to B, 2A square equal to 8. That means A equal to 2, B equal to 2. A plus B is what, 4 over. So this you got correct. So, length of diagonal you got correct, 4. So, both two options are correct. Two options are correct. Now, W bar is an angular bisector or not in this case, we can easily check. Already checked. PR bar is what? PR bar is nothing but 2AI. That means 4I. Previously, what I got, I will get I plus J. These two are not collinear vectors. Therefore, it cannot be angular bisector. Now look at this correct you got, this wrong you got. Now look at, in this case we have taken it is a square. Now you got the vectors. Look at, now let us find the projections of the vector. If that is root 2, our square is correct. So look at, then we will take this vector w bar, and we have taken the square and I got that. So length of projections, let us say draw like this. Whether we will check, we have taken it is a square, we can check whether this place this equal to root 2 I am getting or not. I will calculate like this, projections, I am dropping perpendiculars like this, this is W bar, now this vector is like this because it cannot be along the angular bisector, right? Now look at AB plus CD, I want to calculate, AB, this is the one, AB, now this CD, I will calculate now. Is nothing but AB plus CD. AB plus CD. If this is root 2, I am getting or not? Let us check. AB is nothing but modulus W bar dot PQ cap. Projection of W bar on PQ bar. Yes? W bar dot PS cap. This. That means W bar is I plus J dot. Now this A you know, B you know. A is 2, B is 2. That means unit vector is what? 2I plus 2J divided by root 8 magnitude plus. Now W bar is I plus J dot PS cap. PS cap is nothing but A is 2, B is 2 divided by root 8. Look at this, what you will get. So this is nothing but, this is nothing but 4 by root 8. So this is nothing but 4 divided by root 8. This is 0. That means 4 divided by root 8 means what? Root 2. So therefore, what he has given the condition, what he has given the condition that you got for these values true. So therefore, our assumption let PQRS be a square is what? Correct. This is another approach. Previously, first we have proved that it is a square and then calculated the remaining. Now, some people cleverly will assume that it is a square. It is a square, we have assumed and calculated everything A and B. Here, another option is there, A minus B equal to 2. That may be correct. So, till here we have assumed. Then, you got A and B. Now, check whether this true or not. If this is true, then your assumption is correct. Like that, problem can be analyzed. Here, in this problem, this directly you can tell. Without solving the problem also, W bar you can easily tell. W bar is whether it is angular bisector or not, we can easily say. Look at, no need to solve anything. PQ is this, PS is this. What is PR bar? PR bar is nothing but, without calculating, in the starting step itself, this plus this, PQ bar plus PS bar, this is 2AI. Whatever may be A, this is 2AI. This cannot be collinear with W bar. By looking at this in the first step itself, you can say this is wrong. This is wrong. So this is clever way of doing. You can do it. You can approach in any way. So this is the first problem given in multiple answer questions. That's the way you have to analyze. Okay. Now. So my main attempt in this solving question paper is how to approach the problem and which concepts you have to use and how to do directly and how to do in an analytical manner. Okay. So this is given for 4 marks. In multiple answer, for part answers are also there. Suppose if 4 options are correct and you have marked the 4, then you will get all 4 marks. Right? Suppose if you have marked a wrong answer, then negative marks will also be there, -1. Right?